Town Cleveland may look nice, but critics say some Cleveland neighborhoods are struggling now worse than ever. Families are facing some of the worst poverty in the country. So what are the candidates for Cleveland mayor planning to do about that? News 5's Derek Waller is live for us. Derek, you asked many of them that very question tonight.
Yeah, Rob, I reached out to a number of candidates appearing on the ballot about this huge problem.
You know, a lot of people lost their houses.
Nohemi Ayala says her Slavic Village neighborhood still has not recovered from the 2008 foreclosure crisis. Many homes sit abandoned, others are rundown rentals.
I think it's really sad that we are not, as a society, looking into that deeper.
Cleveland's poverty rate dipped last year, but at around 35%, it's still among the worst in the country. And the city's population has dropped by nearly 50,000 people in about the last decade.
It's not a new phenomenon.
John Corlett with the Center for Community Solutions said people living in poverty tend to live in high crime neighborhoods with less access to fresh food and good schools.
Cleveland has typically had a higher percentage of people living in poverty than other similar cities in the state or other cities in the country.
What would you be doing differently as mayor that you haven't already done?
We would clearly be talking to the private sector every single day.
Ward 2 Councilman Zach Reed said he'd put public pressure on private businesses to hire city residents. And Ward 10 Councilman Jeff Johnson said we need higher wages.
That to impact poverty, you got to raise the minimum wage.
Then there's education. The Republican Party's candidate Robert Kylo wants more charter schools, similar to the respected breakthrough schools he was once part of.
You've got less than seven out of 10 kids graduating from Cleveland High School.
Fresh Fruit Tea's founder Tody Matalone said proven educational nonprofits need more funding.
Everything comes down to funding, and if you don't fund the programs that work, then those programs can't scale.
And finally, Brandon Krostowski told me he wants more job training, like what's done at his Edwin's restaurant. They prepare former prison inmates for careers in food service.
You know, downtown looks great. The marketing for Cleveland's been great, but we're still the number one distressed city.
And a spokesman for Mayor Frank Jackson said he was not available tonight. There is much more detail about this inside the News 5 app. The mayoral primary is September 12th. Live in Cleveland, Derek Waller, News 5.